All right, so we are rolling. Greetings, Virgo. That's you guys. This is Tara Illumination over here, and we're doing a little micro video about the ingress of Jupiter in Sagittarius. Okay, it just started end of 2018, going most of the way through 2019. It's kind of a big deal for the whole planet. We never made a video about Uranus. I'm sorry about that. Maybe we will, but right now I'm just trying to keep up with everything. So this is most we can do for now. There's no good tarot cards here or anything. The reason why we're making these little videos for Jupiter and Sagittarius is so that we have a reference point here at Tarot Illumination, especially for all of you and the members in particular who are likely to see this, and then we can use it in future conversations and readings as we go along, and we can refer back to this. You know, every reader has different interpretations, and I'm just going to give you a snapshot of the Tarot Illumination perspective, and so that you know where Tarot Illumination stands, and then you can reinterpret however you like. Okay, thank you for listening, Virgo. Let's get into it. Now, picture Jupiter, the great benefic, the great healer, the bringer of fortune, the bringer of adventure, the inspiration to seek and find higher knowledge, wisdom, forge new territories, cross new horizons, go way, way out of your comfort zone into new adventures, the energy of exploration, discovery, learning more, discovering more, the thirst for knowledge, higher consciousness, getting as close as you can to understanding the workings of heaven, and so on. Now, you put that through the lens of Sagittarius and all the optimism that goes with it, it's kind of multiplied. Now, if you want to, I like to do this. I like to think of Jupiter and Sagittarius as the beginning of this epic 12-year journey that Jupiter takes as it goes around the whole solar system. And through that journey, it takes roughly 1 year to go through each piece of the pie chart of the Western astrological symbol. And so I like to think of this as the beginning of that 12-year journey. So, Virgo, you can think back. What was your life like 12 years ago, right now? If you can do that, that might give you a glimpse of what you might expect. Something expanded, got better, changed, improved in that part of your life where Sagittarius rules, okay? So we're going to look at that in a moment. I want to show you what the journey looks like from here from Tarot Illumination. So this is the 12-year journey, okay? If you think of this as the planet, if you think of this as Jupiter, zooming around the solar system, and there's all of us here with our sun signs and so on, moon and rising and so on. And it's a 12-year epic journey, okay? All well established in the world of astrology and mythology. And now we're bringing in the focus really tight down to here, the 1-year journey for each sign. And it starts here. Pretend that's Jupiter. And it's going to take a year to cross through Sagittarius, okay? So you will have a specific degree trigger point here where Sagittarius lies, whether you have planets there or not. This part of your chart exists somewhere, okay? So for Virgos, it's going to be looking sort of like this, okay? You'll see this in a moment. I just wanted to get some understanding about the journey here for all of us on record. Okay, now let's get back to you specifically, Virgo. Where does all this good fortune and beneficence and healing apply to you and the expansion in your life and world? Well, here it is. This is a Tarot Illumination astrodoodle trying to explain it as best as possible. This is you, Virgo. I'm putting you on the horizon on a Western astrology chart, super ultra simplified. Sagittarius is over here. It's your fourth house, okay? So Jupiter rules this part of your chart. And Jupiter just started. You can imagine Jupiter's right here, okay? And it's going to take a year to traverse this part of your life and your world. This part of your life and your world is the fourth house. So think about that. Home, family, foundations, the place where you sleep, rest, and nurture. All the Cancerian energy of home and family. Now apply all that Jupiter energy through the lens of Sagittarius, okay? Here's what Tarot Illumination feels. Please allow and consider and look for and expect for new locations, new relocations, or let's say upgrades in your existing location that allow for broader perspectives, especially when it considers or what impacts your home, your family, your place of residence, okay? You might be moving. You might be moving to foreign lands, to another state, to another neighborhood, something like that, above and beyond what you're used to. Please allow for foreign locations, new locations, okay? And all of this would be beneficial for you, okay? Jupiter brings benefits, okay? It is the great benefic. And healing. I like to think of it as healing too. Please allow and consider for new foundations for your outer life, okay? Because what happens here in your home is going to affect what happens out here in your, let's say, destiny. So please allow for that over here in the 10th house. Please consider and allow for good luck and benefits, healing in and with and from a new environment, a new home setting, and new vibes in the home. Maybe it's time to remodel. Maybe it's time to refurbish, repattern, rearrange the furniture, whatever it is, to make things better, happier, more healthy, more abundant. You know, get rid of the old stuff that doesn't work and bring in the new and the modern and allow yourself to feel as though you're on a new epic adventure, starting from your home. Now, even though this energy here is like technically, this is on the hard angles, these are the angles here. It's technically, you could call it a square to the Virgo energy. You can still benefit. I mean, that's what Jupiter wants. Even though it might be challenging for you, like if you're experiencing upheavals and relocations, in some way, form, or other, it's still ultimately for your benefit and your best outcome. That's all Jupiter wants for you is to be better, happier, more abundant, and expand and grow in this part of your life. Okay? You can get spiritual awakening. You can get healing. You can get wisdom and greater understanding between yourself and family, between family and yourself. Okay? All of those things can happen. When, just think of it as to do with family and home and foundations, stability and security of your physical life over here. Okay? So, all the best, Virgo. I hope you get something out of this. And just keep it in mind for future shows and videos and so on. Okay? Thank you so much. I'm going to put this, I'll just leave that there. You take care. Bye bye. Bye bye, Virgo.